The rousing chimes of white jade purify the 10 directions and bring peace to the rivers and oceans. The high peaks bear the weather, the myriad spirits bow, questing the presence of the immortals. Heaven is freed of impure air, earth is freed of all temptation. Obscure wisdom clearly perceived. So vast and generous is the mystery of the mystery. Immortal of the great veiled three treasures, Daluo, Sambao, Tianzun. May your numinous voice pervade every place, extinguishing wrongs, dissolving transgressions. Being upright in our spine, being upright in our life, the numinous voice, the resonance of the chimes, is the opportunity to clear, extinguishing wrongs, dissolving transgressions. May your treasured signs pervade every time, coming to the aid of those in need. The words, the ink, the kind of resonance. May this altar be open so the teachings in these verses manifest. May our efforts be meritorious and in alignment with the teachings that follow. May all our effort gather merit. Through our alignment and following of the teachings. Ascending to the highest altar with the Stepping Toward Emptiness song. We pray that the lands be blessed and avoid even the shortest drought. Today our pure hearts present at the golden watchtower within, amidst the morning's peaceful haze of incense, the jade furnace burns. Turning our intention up to the sacred is an offering like the smoke of the incense. And the jade furnace burns as if we're being watched by spirit, but we are that spirit, and so that awareness is the heat and aliveness that is burning. Transform. The central territory is fortified. Our bodies are upright and centered. Mountains and rivers are robust. Our body is stable. The rivers of our meridians flow free and full of essence. The immortal's splendor is expansive, radiating, radiant. And the saints and sages are luminous, bright, aware. When we all pay respects to the ancient sages each day, orienting back and forward and up, the year's harvest, the fruit of this cycle, is plentiful. When people enjoy peace and tranquility, body and life are carefree. Immortal of constant clarity and constant stillness. Constancy is this clarity and this stillness, together as one uninterrupted constancy. When the realized mind is clear and still, the Tao has fulfilled our ancestral purpose. In constancy, we have returned to the root. Like the culmination of the pearl moon. May the darkness be swept from our minds until no obstacles remain. And a full circle of light fills the great void. The highest medicine is within the body, Shen, Qi, Jing. Each of us has the capacity to eliminate deficiency and excess. May we come to know the primordial unity, the original singularity, by reversing the way, gathering instead of dispersing. To nurture each day the yellow sprout and the golden tripod. Shoring up our intention. Protecting that at first precarious confidence and recognition in seeing things as they are. That yellow sprout. Before the altar, we are all the same, each of us reverent within and without. To our heartfelt summons, the Tao replies, so we recite these scriptures and follow the teaching. Purifying the mind. Tai Shang, Tai Xing, adapting to change without end, expelling evil and binding demons, protect my destiny and guard my body. May my wisdom be luminous and pure, the spirit of my heart, mind at peace, my three Hun everlasting, and my Po undying. Ji Ji Wu Li. Purifying the speech. Don Ju, spirit of the mouth, expel the filth and foul air so Jung Lun, spirit of the tongue, can infuse my destiny with spiritual nourishment. Luo Chen, spirit of the teeth, reject perversity and protect truth. So Hu Bun, spirit of the throat, can guide down the liquid spiritual qi. Don Yuan, spirit of the heart, enable me to penetrate reality, so Lien Yi, spirit of thought, can constantly abide in the Tao. Ji Ji Wu Lu Ning. We have the opportunity to relate with aliveness to the denser aspects of our spiritual being, in our teeth as guards, our breath expels the filth and foul air. purifying the body. Ling Bao Tian Sun. Comfort my body. Tame my Hun and Po. Harmonize my five organs. Wu Zong Shun Ming. It's actually an indication of the original spark in the body. If it's present, then everything is flourishing and harmonized. May the green dragon and white tiger command my bewildered mind. Bring to order the entangled turbidity. May the red phoenix and dark warrior guard my body. This turning inward can be vulnerable. To have a relationship of, build the intention of protection can be supportive. Gigi, move in. Purifying heaven and earth, cutting away the weeds. Heaven and earth in their natural state. Foul chi scatters. Deep within the mysterious emptiness is the radiant clarity, the great source or origin. In the eight directions, the spirits inspire awe and deliver me to my natural state. The mandate of the Ling Bao talisman reverberates through the nine heavens. Mandate being the conversion, salvation toward full recognition by all sentient beings. The generals Gan Luo and Da Na penetrate the Dipper's great mystery. Demons are cut down, evil is bound, the myriad ghosts are slain. The central mountain Shenzhou, spirit incantation. Yuan Shu's jade script. Perfected writing. I hold and chant one time, preventing illness, prolonging life. The five sacred peaks restrain the phases. Across the eight oceans, the revelation is recognized. Like a dog who spots a bird, it's freezing to take note. The demon king surrenders and now stands guard at my terrace. What was against us is now for us. The inauspicious is completely dispersed. The chi of the Tao is constant. Perpetual. Gigi, remember me. Established our orientation toward the sacred. Our lowering and loosening of ourselves. And raising up primordial unity. And we've begun purification through the incantations. Remove the obstacles to our recognition that primordial unity. And now we establish and re-establish the view in our relationship to the structure of reality, our relationship to words and concepts, to doing and non-doing. Jing Jing Jing, the scripture of constant clarity and stillness, is spoken by Taishong Lao Jun, the deified Lao Tzu. The great Tao is without form. It gives rise to heaven and earth. The initial yin and yang, that is form being formed, comes out of no form. Or is also simultaneously no form. The great Tao is without sentience. It moves the heavenly cycles, feeling and thought as a kind of representation of the dynamic interplay of yin and yang in heaven and earth. So it's without movement, but it moves. The great Tao is without name. It nourishes earthly existence. Unbounded, unnameable, it's the source of vitality, essence. I do not know its name. Forced to name it, I call it the Tao. Every particular instance of the Tao has clarity and also has turbidity, has movement and also has stillness. Clarity is of heaven and turbidity of earth, movement of heaven, stillness of earth. Clarity is male, turbidity is female, movement is male, stillness is female. These two together contain each other. Descending from the root, formlessness, and flowing to the branches, the 10,000 things. The Tao gives rise to all things. Clarity develops out of turbidity. Movement is founded upon stillness. Human beings have the capacity to be constantly clear and still. Heaven and earth always return to the source. So in the midst of 10,000 things, always is the primordial unity, the emptiness, non-being. Spirit is drawn to clarity, but the mind disturbs it. The mind is drawn to stillness, but desires pull it away. If you are able to constantly let go of desires, the mind naturally achieves stillness. This is also a framing, an alchemical framing, where the work is letting go of desires, and desires stand in for not just wanting, but also rejecting, impulses that keep us in the 10,000 things, as opposed to the unity, the root. If you are able to constantly be free of desires, the mind is naturally still. When the mind is clear and still, the spirit naturally achieves clarity. The next stage in alchemy. In this natural state, the six desires do not arise, and the three poisons are completely dispelled. Six desires, one for each sense, including the mind. Three poisons: anger, greed, and ignorance. If you're not like this, the mind is not yet clear. Desires have not been let go. When desires can be let go, inwardly observing one's mind does not exist. Outwardly observing one's body does not exist. Looking deeply into phenomena, phenomena do not exist. They have no inherent existence, solid existence that is resistant to change, that is perpetual and constant. The only thing that's constant is the being, non-being. Fully awakened to these three things, we thus perceive emptiness, true emptiness. Observe that emptiness is also empty. Emptiness cannot exist and be actually empty. Actual emptiness is entirely non-existent. Non-existence of non-existence is also non-existent. Non-existence of non-existence is precisely non-existent. Allow that to mean that if non-existence is a thing that we are naming with a bounded understanding, then it is not the thing that is meant to point to. Nature is fathomless and constantly silent. If the silence cannot exist and be silent, how can desires have any real reality? How can desires come into being? If even silence, if even non-existence is not existent, how can these things that we want and reject be real? Desires never coming into being, realizing stillness is precisely this. Realizing constancy is adapting to existing. Constant realization. Follows. Allows. Not chase or reject. Realizing constancy is recognizing innate nature. bright stillness that is imperceptible and at the center. Clear and still like this, gradually integrate and realize Tao. Nourishing the yellow sprout and the golden tripod. Completely integrating and realizing the Tao. Sprout bearing fruit, flowering, the golden flower, is called attaining the Tao. Though it is called attaining the Tao, nothing is attained. To support the realization of all sentient beings, we call it attaining the Tao. Because before Tao, we are in the 10,000 things, a narrative construct. So the name, if we are forced, is the Tao, and the relationship is attainment. Someone who is awakened in this way can transmit the sacred Tao. The structure, the alchemy, and now the behavior, a relationship in our everyday narrative. A skillful person does not strive, the unskillful person strives. The higher virtue is not virtuous, the lower virtue carries out virtue. Virtue that is carried out is not the virtue of the Tao. We align ourselves with our precepts, but we should always recognize practicing and following those precepts is not the Tao itself. It prepares us, gives us the opportunity to get out of the way and allow the Tao to generate and behave naturally in alignment with those precepts. But it is not. The Tao itself. The reason all living beings are not immortals is because of their errant minds. Not being in alignment. Having an errant mind startles the spirit. The spirit pulls back, the mind goes forward. Fully startling one's spirit promptly brings forth the 10,000 things. I want, I don't want. Fully bringing forth the 10,000 things promptly gives rise to greed and grasping. Promptly giving rise to greed and grasping promptly gives rise to worry and stress. Worries and errant thinking distress the body and mind. But it is useless to experience such confusion and shame, recklessly following the current from birth to death, as opposed to this reversal. Constantly immersed in the world of suffering, tethered to 10,000 things, perpetually lacking a true Tao, or Taoist reality. Realization. With true constancy as his path or her path, an awakened person is content in themselves. If one awakens to the Tao, constant clarity and stillness is accomplished. The immortal Gu Wong says, I attain the true Tao by reciting this scripture 10,000 times. These statements are part of the scripture to remind us of the value and breadth and depth and like in the last discussion last week as I was trying to bring your attention to the value of what you have. These statements reestablish that each time. Those who study this scripture become celestial beings. Do not reveal it to anyone unworthy. Eminent supreme beings of the East transmitted it at the Golden Watchtower. At the Golden Watchtower, the supreme beings transmitted it to the Queen Mother of the West. The Queen Mother of the West always transmitted it orally, never writing it down. To serve this generation, this kalpa, this life cycle, this cycle of being, I have written it down in a book. Higher practitioners will awaken to it, ascending to the heavenly offices. Middle practitioners will cultivate with it and join the Southern Palace Immortals. Lower practitioners will hold it and live a long life. This hierarchy is pragmatic, it's not a judgment. It's for some people, having a relationship to the scripture will be the correct support in this lifetime. Others will use it in its chemical transformative properties, and still others will be fully awakened and realized through their relationship to the scripture. Zhou Xuan Junrun says, those who study the Tao and recite this scripture gain the good graces of heaven. Spirit supports their body. The jade talisman protects their spirit. And the golden liquid refines their physical form. Recitation as alchemy. Form and spirit together miraculously unite the Tao and merge with reality. Jung Yi Junrun says, those who have awakened to this scripture, with those who have awakened to this scripture, calamity and obstacles will not interfere. Innumerable saints will guard the gate, while their spirits ascend to the higher realm to worship. In the higher reality, merit and virtue are fulfilled as we resonate with the immortals and sustain our recitation without diminishment until our bodies ascend on a purple cloud. we're shaping our behavior with the precepts, we reduce the rate of accumulation of entanglement. The alchemical practices we refine, transform, transmute entanglement. And give up the inner sentience, the movement, an opportunity to self-harmonize. Our relationship to the sacred. And to extraordinary confidence in our understanding of the view. We give ourselves the opportunity recognize constant clarity and stillness as the fundament of being. There is nowhere that it is not. quietness and our stillness before our more active alchemical practice. In our expansive, subtle perception, we can wait. Till we notice the energy begin to rise on its own. Carry onward. The slow, slow, steady, steady inhale. Gather through the lungs and through the pores. Holding when you're full. Comfortable, you can compress within the hold. Diaphragm down, lower belly in and up, perineum up. Release the compression, finish with the hum. Again, slow and steady, as if you're pulling thread of silk. If you pull too quickly, it'll snap. You'll begin again. If you're comfortable after the home, compress again. Inhale, slow, steady. pores, lungs. Sustaining your subtle sense, staying quiet inside. Two more.
Mm-hmm.
Earth heart embraces all. Movement slow and steady like the breath. To support maintaining the subtle sense, pulling that delicate thread through the entire practice. Inhale, hold, hoo, silently, three times at your own pace. Acceptance, forgiveness. Demons now stand guard at our gate. Protecting new life. Energy and heat all bound up, knot entanglement generates pain. Releasing that knot lets that same heat nourish. Let's do one more. This time, add the intention on the inhale of gathering. Gathering into a high pain point. Allow the who to do the work of forgiveness and letting go. Inhale and transition, three-part transition. Exhale with shoo. Silent. again. Cycling chin and ku. Again. Out of non-being, Qian unity, Kun earth being, exhale, Shu. Hidden cycles, repeat, always present. Non-being. Shu. Being. Slow, steady, continuous resting, moving the silken thread, constant attention. With great confidence in your understanding of the view, gather, transition. And with the strength of a sincerity that comes only from confidence. Pierce the veil. With great confidence in the efficacy of great confidence. And having left the need for confidence behind. recognizing the unity within transition. Recognizing, permeating boundlessness. Center without location, and the vastness without boundary. Cycle of Qian Kun. Six times. The pores, the lungs, kidneys, tailbone. After this high hey, transition directly to the om without a next breath.
Hold your breath out if you can. Then relax and let the breath be. Come forward if it's comfortable. energy pouring into your crown. Inhale and rise up.
Above Mount Kunlun, reflecting and illuminating inside. We are the refraction of the newness. Jing Jing Wu Wei, Taiji Mudra.